session. And as I told you that my tea has come little late, I'll mute my video. But as soon as my tea is over, but I'll continue the lecture so that we should not waste the time. let's go back to briefly what was transpired during the first 90 minutes of the session for those of you who could have joined little later. First thing, the title of the presentation, I took it as the building the competencies of the teachers in the blended learning environment. Then, of course, I have told you that why that blended learning is important, because students are at home and will be having two levels of interaction, and only one level of interaction will not work in this mode. The two levels of interactions are, the first one is we will be speaking over the, of course, students may be coming to the campus one day or 2 days or 3 days, and remaining time they will be managing from home. So you have to create the environment in such a way that students will be having these two type of things. So to do this, what is important is we need to understand the six essential elements. Can I request one of the participants to tell what are the six essential elements? The six essential element. Tarunya Multani? Ya, koi aur ho. Wo six essential elements ke baare mein kuch bata sakte hai, sir? Koi na?
Sir, it's a plan design, first one. Development. Okay. Then delivery. The fourth one is a transaction. Okay. Then the fifth one is activities and assessment. And the sixth one is an interaction.
Great. So the first and foremost thing to do this kind of an environment, like, you know, engaging the students out of the classroom and in classroom learning. So there are two important, when we need to understand, first and foremost thing, we need to plan and design our course. For planning and design our course, planning and designing ka matlab mera ye hai ki bhai dekhiye, student kuch time tak aa rahe hain ya college bhi nahi aa rahe, ab to hafte mein to do din hum online mein padhayenge, online mein lecturing le lenge, padhane ka matlab hai everything is online now. But I can use these two words, in classroom learning and out of the classroom learning. In classroom learning, mera matlab ye tha, if the students are there in front of you, in a physical presence of the students. Second one is about the out of the classroom learning, the learning from home. So first and foremost thing is planning and designing is very important. The second point is, we require the pedagogy. What is the pedagogical approaches we are going to use it? Okay, it could be a flipped classroom pedagogy, or it could be any other, because there is something called learner-centric MOOC. So one pedagogical approach is also very much important. The third important, rather I should say the second important thing here is the resources. Resources are of two types. So some resources you are going to prepare, some resources you have to, you should collect it and collate it from other sources. Okay, first important point is planning and designing, which is also consisting of pedagogical interventions. Second important thing is about the content. Some part of the content ko maine do tukdon mein baata tha, do guton mein baata tha rather. One is about the core resources. Second one is about the, I think somebody is saying something, please. Dr. Gajanan, is it, can you hear me?
My voice is clear, sir? Yes.
Okay. Because somebody suddenly somebody is speaking in Marathi. I'm understanding the, so I thought maybe they may be asking a question. Jai Maharashtra. So the second question, third point which I'm trying to say in this regard is the content. Content is again two types. One is core resources, second one is supplementary resources. The type of the content is, I am saying that it could be audio, it could be video material, it could be audio material, it could be a text material, it could be anything else also. So second one is about the resources. What is the third important point? What is the third important point? The third important point is strategies for. बताइए ना आप लोग को भी बता नहीं रहे. What is the third important point which I discussed?
It is the delivery.
It's a delivery platform. Exactly. Yes. Exactly. It's a delivery platform. So strategies for the delivery platform. What does it mean? The strategies for the delivery platform means. Yeah. It's a course delivery platform. Please try to understand carefully. Basically, a course delivery platform. So we need to understand what are those course delivery platforms which we would be able to use. Can I request you to kindly switch on your monitors, please? Cameras, please, for some time. I have a little difficulty. I'll switch on for a minute because I'm having a cup of tea. It does not look nice to me professionally to while having a tea in front of you. So the third important thing is about the delivery platform. Okay, in a blended teaching, how many delivery platforms you are having? And what are they? Please be interactive. Dr. Bhartu Deshmukh. Madam, can you please tell me?
So actually, there are many platforms like we have Google platform.
How many delivery platforms? Pehle ye bataiye, one or two?
Actually, in between, I had left the lecture, but still, I would like to say that.
I'm asking you in a blended mode of teaching, there will be two delivery platforms.
Okay.
What are the two delivery platforms? Number one,
online and offline.
When the students are coming to the campus, when the students are in front of you, when they are coming towards your campus, they then the teacher will be. It's only a lecture, but that's one delivery platform. Second delivery platform is when the students are at home. And in a offline learning environment, so they may be using a learning management system. Also, apart from the learning management system, students are also, we can interact with the students using the synchronous learning platforms like WebEx, like Google Meet, like Zoom, and so on and so forth. So the third one is, strategies for the delivery platforms means when the students are coming to the campus or when you are lecturing the students online, that is one platform. Second one is when the students are at home. So what type of a planning need to be done? So that is about point number three. Next, go to point number four. What is point number four? Dr. Abhilasha, what is point number four? Dr. Abhilasha Roth, Jeevan.
Yes,
ma'am. What is point number four, madam?
Point number four is transaction.
Strategies for the transaction. So that means, how do we transact this code? I think this is what we need to learn. This is what it is very much required here. So transaction means when the students, when you are giving a lecture, it's not enough. Before the lecture, like, you know what happened? Yesterday, I requested Dr. Preeti to create a WhatsApp group. She has already created. I shared some reading material to you. I assume that you people will go through that reading material. Okay? Second one is, once you have a reading material has gone through that, so that it's easier for me to transact in a classroom. I always say this. When students will come to class, and afterwards the class ke baad bhi kuch material unko denge, then the total things will be little different. That's what the transaction is about. Then comes the activities and assessment. What are the activities we can prepare? What are the assessments we have prepared? Ye kyu karna chahiye? Sabse important, kai baar hum is mahol mein nahi padhte ke are nahi nahi bacche samajh mein aayega unko. See, we are having different types of students in the class. We have slow learners, we have average learners, we have gifted learners. Slow learners, average learners, gifted learners. And we have introverts. Kuch class mein bolte nahi hai. Online mein to bolenge. Kuch extroverts. Class mein hi bolenge, bahar nahi bol payenge. So all type of, and communication is language is a big issue. You know, whether you like it or not, I've been speaking in English. Okay, like most of our classes are Marathish, Marathi plus English, Telugu plus English, Tamil plus English, like this, we have been doing it. So my point is that I think this is the way when communication is very important, so that whichever the language, the students are comfortable, the teachers are comfortable, should go on. I'm not saying that English is the only, fine, it's okay. But if I'm comfortable in Marathi, if I'm comfortable in Hindi, if I'm comfortable in Gujarati, if I'm comfortable in Telugu, allow them to speak. See, we cannot be an expert on the day. So that's how, but my point is that in a face-to-face environment, student can ask. In a virtual environment, there's a discussion forum, this can be done. And the last very important point is interaction. The success and failure of your blended learning course, not only blended, your MOOCs courses, not only your MOOCs course, your online and open distance courses, is depends on the level of the interaction you do. Aajkal to aapne bhi suna hoga, mere course mein 10,000 logo ne join kiya, 20,000 logo ne join kiya. We are not political affiliated people. We are all teachers. My logic is simple. We want to see that to the extent possible, how many of them can take the advantage. Okay, so interaction plays a major role. What are the things to be covered in interaction? Three things. How do we engage the learner? I hope you have been writing all these things. How do you engage the learner? How do you motivate the learner? Engage, motivate, and encourage. Engage, encourage, and motivate. Motivation is very important. Engagement is very important. Encouragement is very important. Now, coming back to these things, and let me repeat once again the six essential elements which I coined very importantly. And these elements are essential to design the blended learning courses, to design the MOOCs courses, and to design the online courses of open and distant learning. First point is course design and course planning and designing. Usme the duration of the course, objectives of the course, expected outcomes of the course, resources, and entire planning, overall planning will be done here. Second point is about the content. And content means, and unfortunately, I'm sorry to say that when we are talking about the content, only we talk about the content development. I'm totally against that. Yes, you can definitely develop the content, but not in the first instance. First of all, try to see that what there are excellent good quality content is available. But kai baar kya ho raha hai, log kehte are yaar kyon itna mehnat kyon kare. Okay, so but again I am telling you, teaching is an art, teaching is a science, teaching is both. Unless and until you involve the teaching, You cannot get, you cannot expect miracles in teaching. You had to spend the time. आपके अंदर भी कई सारे रिसर्च गाइड्स होंगे. We had to spend 3 to 4 years, 5 years with our research scholar to get the quality out of it. Gunvatta, there is no second thought to that. And many times there is a comment I have been hearing from many of the faculty saying, "Sir, हमारे syllabus पुराने हैं." Syllabus पुराने हो सकता है. But my point is, what is stopping you to innovate in your classroom? What is stopping you to innovate in the classroom? Experiential learning. देखिए मैं आपको साइकिल कैसे चलाना वीडियो दिखाने से बजाय एक बार प्रैक्टिकल करके दिखा दो. So that's the reason keeping in view, I had given you one project work. सारे इसलिए मैंने आपको प्रोजेक्ट वर्क दिया था. तो उस प्रोजेक्ट वर्क में यू विल एक्सपीरियंस दैट. एक्सपीरियंशियल लर्निंग इज वेरी 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 इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर अस. सो इन द प्रोजेक्ट वर्क मैंने आपको क्या कहा था, यू ट्राई टू डिजाइन ए सैंपल ब्लेंडेड कोर्स विच इज ऑफ 2 weeks ड्यूरेशन. मतलब 2 हफ्ते के कोर्स है. 2 हफ्ते मतलब 14 days. इमेजिन द सिनेरियो, 2 days इन ए वीक स्टूडेंट्स आर कमिंग टू द कैंपस or 2 days you will be interacting using the WebEx platform. Number one. Second component is, remaining 5 days the student should learn from home. बच्चे घर से ही पढ़ेंगे. तो आपसे पूछेंगे, सर आप 2 दिन WebEx से पढ़ना, 5 दिन घर से पढ़ने में क्या फर्क है? फर्क है. कैसे फर्क है? 2 days you will speak on the over the WebEx platform, they will listen to your lectures, but remaining 5 days they will learn, but with the help of the processes and procedures which they are going to use. Okay, in both the case the teacher is very important, no doubt about it. Teacher interaction is very important. That's the reason I said setting up of the environment is very important. माहौल बनाना बहुत जरूरी है. That's not my quote, the great Albert Einstein's quote. Setting up of the environment where learning happens. So this is where you need to be here. So that project I had given. Okay. Second point in that project work, what did I say? You had to prepare some content that I call it as a core resources. It could be a video content. It could be a text content. It could be audio content. That is a small videos you have to prepare. Fine. If you could able to prepare 5 minutes properly, 55 minutes also can be possible. कई बार लोग मुझे पूछते, अरे प्रोफेसर श्रीनिवास जी ने 5 मिनट का ही क्यों कहा था? अरे भैया 5 मिनट का बनाओगे ना, 55 मिनट भी चलेगा. But what is important is the process is more important to me. And we are struggling, friends. I must tell you one thing. We are struggling to get the faculty members into 5 important areas, books development. We need a faculty member, subject expert, to face the camera. You know why we are giving this exercise of developing the small videos? If you can start getting into this mode, tomorrow you will be getting, you can face the camera without much difficulty as such. First one. Second one, along with the video facing, we need the faculty members who should prepare focused PowerPoint presentation. Using the PowerPoint, you can prepare the video. So focused PowerPoint banana, we should know. The third point, first one is facing the camera. Second one is preparing the focused PowerPoint presentation. The third important thing is writing a focus script. Writing the focus script. स्क्रिप्ट का मतलब क्या है? मान लो कि मैंने 5 मिनट का वीडियो बनाने के लिए आपको कहा था. What I am asking? What to show? What to highlight? That means what to show means what to highlight, what to speak, and what extent to speak. This is need of the hour. Within 5 minutes, you had to put up these things. If it is time extended, yes, you can do. So the focused way of presentation, so the presenter is a subject expert. He or she will look at the PPT. एंड आपको पता है कितना बहुत नौटंकी होते कैमरा के सामने फेस करने से. लोग कहते हैं अभी फर्स्ट टाइम अभी तो काफी साल हो गए, वो कैमरा के पीछे बंदा खड़ा होता है, सर डॉक्टर साहब सीधा देखो, देख लिया जी सर आप गर्दन लेफ्ट हो गए, हाँ जी सीधा कर लो सर ज्यादा सीधा हो गया, राइट पकड़ राइट कर दिया जी सर आप हंसो सर ज्यादा हंस रहे हो सर ऐसा करो, इट इज नॉनसेंस. माय पॉइंट इज दैट प्लीज ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड, यू लुक एट द आउटसाइड वीडियोस, ऑक्सफर्ड, हार्वर्ड, याले, किंग्स कॉलेज, सो मेनी टॉप मोस्ट इंस्टीट्यूशन, दे आर ऑल बी नेचुरल. बट हमारे यहाँ तो पूरा भयभीत होके बोलता है कैमरा के सामने. मैं कहता हूँ यार ऐसे वाई शुड वी सी, आवर पर्पस इज टू फैसिलिटेट द लर्निंग एंड दैट टू, इट्स नॉट ओनली द पैसिव लर्निंग, वी आर लुकिंग फॉर ए एक्टिविटी बेस्ड. नोट ऑफ दिस पॉइंट, आई विल कम बैक टू दिस. आई राइट नो एवरीथिंग, आई एम जस्ट नॉट, I'll try to connect these. So we are looking the faculty member who can face the camera. We are looking the faculty member to face the prepare the focused PPT. We are expecting a faculty member to learn how to prepare the script. And fourth important thing is we want a faculty member to spend the time for editing of this video. We require a faculty member to find time to edit the video. When somebody is editing the video, only subject expert can speak. And the last one is, we are looking for a faculty member who has this expertise in searching the good quality supplementary resources. Supplementary resources. And any technical fellow, haan sir, right click karo, left click karo, ho jayega. No. We want a subject expert who understand the objectives, who understand the expected learning outcomes, and also they want to see that how the supplementary video material need to be prepared at all. You understand now? That's the reason these workshops, we are giving these activities. That is the reason for that purpose. Okay. Now, what I'm trying to say, let me go back to my screen now, friends. So I think I'll try to give you. Let me start with that the supplementary reading material. Where are the supplementary reading material? There are excellent source of supplementary reading material which is already available in front of you. One of the source of the supplementary reading material is that. Kindly confirm to me, my PPT is visible on your screens, please.
Madam Abhilasha? Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes,
sir. Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Yes, sir.
So, the one of the important source of the supplementary reading material could be from the digital initiatives of Government of India and the state government initiatives in higher education. Pichle do saalon mein, Rajya Sarkaron ne bhi, एंड ऑफकोर्स केंद्र सरकार भी बहुत सारे पहलुओं को लेके आया. एंड वी वॉन्ट टू टेक द एडवांटेज ऑफ दिस डिजिटल इनिशिएटिव्स ऑफ गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया इन हायर एजुकेशन. एंड लेट मी शेयर दिस स्क्रीन, लेट मी शेयर दिस प्रेजेंटेशन टू यू इन द चैट बॉक्स. गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया, state governments, higher education. Okay, friends, this is about, I already shared with you, so kindly have a look into this, please. So the digital initiatives of Government of India and state government in higher education. The first one is about this Swayam platform. You all know very well that Swayam is India's finest government-funded MOOCs platform, where a good quality archival course content is available, which could be useful for your blended courses. First of all, you need not create any content as such. Second, Swayam Prabha. This is available in web version. This is available in mobile version also. 34 free DTH channels are there, and you should take the advantage of. There are good quality archival videos content is available. And live videos are available. We can use it as a good quality reading material in our classes. National Digital Library, I need not explain. So much content is already there. EPG Pathshala. EPG Pathshala is again one of the very, very important source of information which is already available with us. UGC MOOCs. UGC MOOCs is again an excellent initiative of Government of India, where you have a good quality archival course content is available. ये बार बार ये बात मैं इसलिए कह रहा हूँ, आपके जो blended learning courses के लिए, अभी मुझे तो ये दो हफ्ते का कोर्स के लिए भी चाहिए, और आगे आपके जो courses के लिए भी अच्छा quality content already उपलब्ध है, ठीक है, इन सारे courses के लिए करने की जरूरत. NROER, National Repository for Open Educational Resources, ये भी एक ऐसे बेहतरीन प्रोग्राम है, इसको यूज कर सकते हो आप. IIT Bombay Spoken Tutorial, हम सबको पता है, वेरी एक्सलेंट एक्सलेंट प्रोग्राम विच इज बीइंग डन IIT Bombay Spoken Tutorial. FOSSI इज वन सच प्रोग्राम विच इज बीइंग अवेलेबल इन ऑनलाइन. Sakshat is again another program, ICT initiatives of Government of India. Virtual Labs, हम सबको पता है, and this is again a program where developed under the ICT initiatives of Government of India. OLAPS, अच्छा, मेरा एक सवाल है, how many of you heard about the OLAPS?
No, sir.
And this is very, very important, sir. And this is basically the digital content mapped to the school syllabus. Amrita University and CDAC Pune, both of them has created this platform. And this is, again, excellent platform available. And we should take the advantage of this kind of a program, which is being available over there. And for those educational faculty, I don't know how many of your education faculty is being studying over here. So we have prepared digital archives of educational documents. We have prepared the digital archives of the educational documents. We have a huge, huge collection of the digital archives. पिछले 75 सालों से बहुत कुछ इसके अंदर हमने दे रखा है. इसके अलावा एक छोटा सा चीज है, शायद मैं बताना भूल गया, एनआरसी there's another program, let me see that if it is opening. There is another program called National Resource Center for Education. I think probably this site may be down, but this is another this is an excellent site. Again, you can use it. I'll come back to that site. Now you see the state specific. Odisha, Kerala, West Bengal, Assam, Maharashtra, and e-Grandhalaya. There are so many initiatives are there. And htedu.maharashtra.gov.in, e-Balbharati, and Vikas. Jammu Kashmir ka bhi hai, SCRT. So there are so many initiatives which in the last 2 years are being developed mostly for the school education and of course for the higher education also. And my request to all of you is try to take these initiatives which will be very, very important and should be used for this purpose as such. Okay. And so my request to all of you is try to make sure that these points. Okay. So these are the some of the ICT initiatives of the Government of India as well as the state government initiatives where you can take the good quality resources. Okay. Let me go back once again. State initiatives से पहले दीपा का डिजिटल आर्काइव्स फॉर एजुकेशनल डॉक्यूमेंट्स, ओलैप्स, वर्चुअल लैब्स, साक्षात, फॉसी, आईआईटी बॉम्बे स्पोकन ट्यूटोरियल, एनआरओईआर, यूजीसी मूक्स, DPG Patshala, National Digital Library, Swayam Prabha, Swayam. Right? So these are the some of the very good quality resources, subject specific resources are available. So we should take the advantage of these type of resources for your teaching learning process. So why I'm telling all these things? For your blended learning courses. This is for the blended learning courses and as well as the supplementary reading material. The next point is you can take the sources from the OER and Creative Commons. So second source of information from open educational resources and Creative Commons sources. Okay, and what are the things which we are going to do? We need to understand what is the OER, understanding the Creative Commons licensing and hands-on practice. Let me give you hands-on one. So here actually what happens here, open educational resources as per the difference. Can I request one of the participants, Dr. Abhilasha, can you read please? Madam, are you available?
Yes sir.
Madam, can you please read the definition, madam, please?
Open educational resources, that is OER, are materials offered freely and openly to use and adopt for teaching, learning, development and research. Commonwealth of Learning.
Dr. Shivani, are you available?
Yes, sir.
Madam, can you please read this slide, madam?
Yeah, sure. Open educational resources, just a minute. Are teaching and learning materials that are freely available online for everyone to use, whether you are an instructor, student, or self-learner. Examples of OER include full courses, course modules, syllabi, lectures, homework assignments, quizzes, lab and classroom activities, pedagogical materials, games, simulations, and many more resources contained in digital media collections from around the world.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, Dr. Shivani and Dr. Abhilasha. Thanks for reading these two slides. So you see that so much content is already available. Okay, but what is important is starting from full courses to the course modules, to the syllabi, to the lecture and homework assignments, pedagogical material. So the question is, what is stopping us not to use this material? Maybe we may say that innocence. We may say that ignorance, but it cannot go beyond that. Okay, so what is this? What is the open in the open content? Yes, of course, so we can retain the content, we can reuse the content, we can revise the content, we can remix it, we can redistribute it. So all these things are automatically happening? No, there is a concept of Creative Commons. Generally, when you create any resource, whether it's an audio resource, video resource, it is your copyrighted one. If the creator to openly declare the level of sharing that is allowed within the work, that is about the Creative Commons. Okay, there is a small video I want to run. Just kindly confirm that are you getting the voice or not, because I'm not comfortable with WebEx. Let me see. Are you getting the noise voice?
No sir.
So what I need to do, share the content voice. Show me in front of the presentation. Like in Zoom, there is a local computer, local audio can be connected. Okay, now tell me.
Yes. No, sir.
Yeah,
no voice.
No. Are you listening?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Preeti, can you please guide me? How can I do this one?
Sir, you directly open it in YouTube. It may be open in that. It is
okay. No. I've been doing the same thing because this is the video. This is one
link.
Okay. If I open the YouTube, it comes automatically.
Yes, sir. Directly it will come.
Let me try that. Let me try that.
You can share your YouTube.
No. I've been doing the same thing. But let me try. Let me try with this one. Production. Can you listen?
No, sir. No voice.
No, I think that's what I'm saying. I think there is some facility available in the WebEx. I could not able to do that. No, in Zoom actually you can share the internal voice. So share the web browser. Let me share the web browser then. Okay, let me share this web browser. I think this is important for me, so that I want you should. Is it coming?
Okay. Sir, आपके स्क्रीन पे नीचे जहाँ पे म्यूट अनम्यूट का ऑप्शन है वहाँ पे कुछ तीन डॉट्स दिए हैं एक्स्ट्रा सेटिंग्स के लिए. So there you can get switch audio. तो उससे
एक बार where?
सर यू स्टॉप स्क्रीन शेयरिंग और इन द अपर पार्ट अभी आपने शेयर स्क्रीन की होगी ना तो ऊपर वाले साइड में आपको जो ऑरेंज कलर की जो स्ट्रिप दिख रही है वहां पे तीन एक्स्ट्रा डॉट्स दिए हैं.
हाँ जी दिए मोर करके.
हाँ मोर करके आप उस पर क्लिक करके स्विच ऑडियो का एक ऑप्शन मुझे दिख रहा है तो वो एक बार ट्राई करके देख सकते हैं.
Switch audio में you are using computer for audio and think चलिए anyway I think why should we waste the time. I think my screen is coming on your screens now, is it okay?
Yes sir it
so
is visible.
Okay
yes, sir.
So the logic is pretty simple. I think every time whenever I'm using the Teams and WebEx this problem is coming. If the Zoom and Google Meet and other things, I never had any problem. Anyway, I think I need to explore this one because there are many videos I embed in my program. So what is basically the Creative Commons is being talking about? It's basically an organization that enables the sharing and use of creativity and knowledge through free legal tools. Okay. So the question is, sir, fine. This is about the Creative Commons. You may be having the additional sessions also. But my process is how to complete that exercise which I had given to you. So there are certain important sites are there. You should understand. So there are about some very good quality OER repositories and platforms are available. I think this has been already shared with madam, but I'll be doing once again. So at least for the project work, I wish you should explore these things. OER repositories, public platforms. And so this is about the OER repositories and platforms. There are so many repositories out there. Okay, I'll show you a few of them. Kindly confirm to me my voice is audible to you, madam.
Yes,
Dr. Bhartu Deshmukh.
Yes, sir. You're audible.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you. So the repositories, like for example, if you are looking for Health Network, African Health Network, OER Network, there are excellent audios and videos are available, text material available. If you are looking for the open textbooks, several areas, statistics to the psychology to the any other methods, you can do that one. Commonwealth of Learning. And this is again a platform where you can get any good quality course contents are available. Reading material is available. There is something on the open textbook library. open textbook library is again a place where you can have a good quality course material. Directory of open access books, directory of OER, Merlot. Generally, when we are searching the content only through our Google browser and Bing browser, but if you can go through this Merlot collection, where other libraries and web, you can see access to curated online learning and support material and content creation tools led by an international community of educators, learners, and researchers. Huge collection of information is available. So you can search this. MIT OpenCourseWare, we all know very well. Nigerian Open University Network, NPTEL, OER Commons, OpenLearn, OpenStax, Skill Commons, you name it. There are so many things are available there. But fine, those things are very much there on that place. But is there any simpler way to search the content? Yes. And for which I'm going to show you something little interesting to you, which is this. Could you please confirm to me this, the concept map is visible on your screens now?
Yes, sir.
So this is basically a concept map of how do we search the content from the open educational resources. There is a tool which is connecting to that. I will explain later. First of all, the outcome of this tool, if you look at, I think you understand now. These are all the simple efforts we should make to make the learning impactful, to make the learning engaging, to make it impactful, engaging. What are the other two, Dr. Shivani?
Motivation, encourage.
Starting में मैंने चार चीज बताया था आपको. Impactful, engaging, interesting, and make it challenging.
Making process,
for the process of learning is for four important things. First one is impactfulness. Second one is engaging. Third one is make it interesting. And last one is challenging. Okay. So what we want to do, how do we now look at so I'm going to explain to you that how this open educational resources are going to be searched. Abhi dekhiye, mera mouse pointer aapko dikh raha hai idhar, iske andar. Just confirm to
yes.
me.
Yes, sir.
Open education, main ek slowly leke ja. Open educational resources can be accessed through, ek option hai, CC search. A open educational resource can be accessed through Google Advanced Search. Third one is through YouTube filter. Sorry. So open educational resources can be accessed through CC search, through Google Advanced Search, through YouTube filter. अभी मैंने आपको जो sites जो दिया था वो सारे CC search के अंदर आता है. चलो आप बाद में देख लीजिएगा. ये गूगल एडवांस सर्च कैसे कर रहे हैं. अब गूगल एडवांस सर्च में मैंने आपको पहले इमेजेस दिखा दूंगा, इमेजेस कैसे सर्च किया जाता है. अब देखिए गूगल एडवांस सर्च कहां से मिलेगा आपको. ओके, नाउ जस्ट हैव ए लुक दैट गूगल एडवांस सर्च में. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल google.com, यू ऑल नो वेरी वेल. यहां मुझे स्क्रिप्ट क्लासरूम के इमेज सर्च करना है. सो कैसे किया जाता है, यू एंटर google.com. स्टेप नंबर वन, इन दिस सर्च बॉक्स, इन दिस बॉक्स, मिडिल बॉक्स, आई विल एंटर स्क्रिप्ट क्लासरूम. व्हाट आई एम गोइंग टू डेमोंस्ट्रेट, हाउ डू वी यूज दिस यू नो गूगल एडवांस सर्च ऑप्शन. यहां तक आने के बाद वी नो स्टेप वन इज ओपन google.com. स्टेप टू, इन द सर्च बॉक्स गिव द कीवर्ड्स. स्टेप थ्री, क्लिक ऑन इमेजेस. स्टेप थ्री, क्लिक ऑन इमेजेस. स्टेप फोर, यू कैन सी ऑल आर नॉट फ्री. आई वांट टू यूज ओनली दोज इमेजेस with under Creative Commons free licensing. कैसे करना है? यहाँ देखिए, इसमें आपको यहाँ दिखाई दे रहे एक tools करके option. Madam, can you please confirm?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
If you click on tools option. If you click on these tools, you can see there are five sub options are coming. One is about the size, second one is about the color, third one is about the type. You can select the type of the image. We can select the time of the image. Okay, time means any time, past 24 hours, pichle hafte, pichle mahine, pichle saal. And the last one is about the usage rights. Under the usage rights, you can see there are three options are there. One is all. All means both Creative Commons licenses and commercial and other licenses. I want to use the Creative Commons licenses. If you click on the Creative Commons licenses, you can see all those video, all those images which are being given over here are the Creative Commons images. You can use this image as per, then give the link. From which link you have been using, and of course Cisco, you can give the information as such, and you can do the info. This is about the Creative Commons. This is the way you can search the Google Advanced Search. Okay, this is about. Next, of course, other things you can try out. But sir, ये तो images आपने इसमें कई बार मुझे images नहीं मिलते. बहुत सारे images तो मुझे मिलते ही नहीं है. तो मुझे क्या करना है? There are certain sites which you can try out. One such site where you can provide good quality, royalty-free images are available is Flickr.com. इसका details भी मैं आपके chat box में डाल रहा हूँ. आप इसको chat box से भी access कर सकते हैं. One is about the Flickr.com. Again. You can get registered yourself and you can get good quality, royalty free images are available. Now, similarly, you have something called pixels.com. Bahut sare sites hai, but main few sites mein aapko mention kar raha hu. Second one is about the pixels.com. Okay. Third one is Pixabay.com. Third one is about the Pixabay.com. First one is Flickr.com. First one is Google Advanced Image Search. Second one is about the Pixels. Second one is about the Flickr.com. Third one is about the Pixels.com. Fourth one is about the Pixabay.com. You can use these sites when you can get good quality images. आप इसको सर्च कर लीजिएगा कौन कौन सा इमेज आपके लिए काम आएगा कौन सा लाइसेंसिंग का पैटर्न दे रखा है. Most of them are Creative Commons and unless and until it is other details are there, तो आप इसको आराम से एक्सेस आप कर सकते हो. Okay, so this is the way you can find out the images. चलिए. Next thing comes the YouTube. ये सारे चीज हम क्यों कर रहे हैं? We need the supplementary material. कभी images भी हो सकता है. अच्छा, let me again go back to one more important thing is about the data capturing template. अब दोबारा मैं ये बात बताना इसलिए चाहता था कि whatever the data, whatever the resource, whether you created the resource or the resource which has been available in the public domain, which you feel it appropriate for the content to be used, you can use this data capturing template, data capturing format, but the four quadrant approach. Video resources ke liye ye bana dijiyega. Similar way for the text resources, similarly for the images point of view, similarly for the audio resources, and all these things can be done for this purpose. Okay, now I'm going to demonstrate to you how do we find out the video resources. Let me go back to the OER part once again. Yahan dekhiyega. Open resources, can be accessed through CC search, हमने देख लिया, through Google Advanced search हमने देख लिया. Now we are going to through, क्या लिखा इधर,
YouTube filters.
So how can we use this YouTube filter to get our open educational resources option? Okay. To do this, what is important is step number one. Go to YouTube.com. Step number two. In the search box, enter the keywords. What are the keywords to be entered? For example, I need to find out a tool, something called computer programming. Okay. So step number two is enter the keywords and press the enter button. But I want not all videos. I want only Creative Commons videos. Can you please tell me that which option I'm highlighting here on your screens?
Filters.
If you click on the filter, you can see there are five types of filters are available on your screen. You can use upload date, you can use type, you can use duration, you can use features, you can use the sort by. These are the filters you can apply. Any one of these filters can be applied. If you are using mobile phone also, isko aram se aap kar sakte ho, koi dikkat nahi. अब ये फीचर्स मेनू के अंदर आप बता सकते हैं मैं कौन सा ऑप्शन को सेलेक्ट कर रहा
हूं?
क्रिएटिव कॉमन्स. सो अब YouTube के अंदर कंप्यूटर प्रोग्रामिंग की कीवर्ड को लेके वी वांट टू सी दैट व्हाट ऑल द यू नो क्रिएटिव कॉमन्स वीडियोस आर अवेलेबल. फॉर एग्जांपल आई वांट टू सेलेक्ट दिस वीडियो. This is Professor Patak from IIT Mumbai. Okay. And this is the video which we are going to. So, but what you see, the, what are the things are there? First one is about the license. The license is a Creative Commons attributed license. It is allowed. So like this, we can search the content from the YouTube also. So what are the steps we did? Step number one. We opened YouTube.com. Step number two, in the search box, we entered the keywords. Step number three, we have entered tools like, then we click on the filter and we find five filter options are there. But under the features menu, we find an option called Creative Commons. We selected. Then the video which is being available there, and you know, we could able to use this video and first of all store this video into the data capturing format. And first of all, go through this video first of all, and what extent this video is going to be used, and accordingly this process can be done. Okay. And why all these things we are discussing? Because of this reason that we want so the project is very important to me. And this project, actually, the supplementary reading material, we are going to use it. Okay. Now, coming back to, apart from this, there is one more things called TED Talks. TED Talks is also another good quality way we can select the material. Good quality material, good quality, simple, video material is available. And we can able to use this part as such. Okay. Now, let me come back to the other resources where we are supposed to be done. There are again good quality resources are also available for developing the content. Now I'm coming to the core resources. Kindly confirm to me my slide is visible to all of you.
Yes, sir.
Can I request one of the participants to kindly read out the contents of the slide, please?
Digital.
Yeah, Shivani, please read.
It's digital content development tools The first is slidator, that is the presentation tube recorder. Then the second one is the OBS studio. Third one is Screencast-O-Matic, that is the desktop or laptop. Then fourth one is FreeCam. Then fifth one is Screencastify. Then it's FreeCam. Seventh one is EPowerSoft. Eighth one is Screencast-O-Matic, the mobile version. And the last one is the GreenShot.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am. So I think there is some small spelling mistake. I think there are some other things. So basically, there are certain tools which are available on your screen. For example, if you look at the Slideator, OBS Studio, and Screencast-O-Matic, these are the simple simple tools where we can generate the application without any difficulty as such. Okay, and followed by four important tools like FreeCam, Screencastify, EPowerSoft, Screencast-O-Matic mobile version, and finally GreenShot. Why? The reason why I'm saying that these are the some of the tools which are easily available. And you can see there are two types of videos we can generate. Number one, there is a using a PowerPoint, we can prepare a video. Second, using a website, you can prepare a video. Using a PDF file, you can generate a video. So the videos, basically, if you look at, has been classified into two important parts. One, content videos. So these content videos will be helpful for the students to assimilate and absorb the content. And of course, this will be very helpful when the students are learning from home. Okay. Second point, so you will be having a focused PowerPoint presentation. Nowadays, people are giving too big PowerPoint for presentations, but everything cannot be assimilated over there. And you can be supplementing this one in the text material. Not everything can be put into that part. Because iske liye effort ki zarurat hai. So many times people are doing good. That's not at all problem as such. Second point is about the demonstration videos. So we can use some tools like Screencastify, FreeCam. These are the tools can be used for that purpose as such. Okay. So some of the tools could be demonstrated during your process as such. There are some excellent comprehensive activity tools are there, like Padlet. And Padlet is an excellent tool. The equivalence of this one is Jamboard. Jamboard and these are the tools which could be a game changer in your blended learning environment. Concept mapping. I have shown one tool about the final output, which was developed with the help of Pyro software, Pyro, and even Google Drawing also. These are the tools which would be, and concept board, Google. Bubbles, as well as the IMAP. These are the tools which could be very much helpful for the concept mapping and as well as the mind mapping tools. The example I have already just now I showed you. Let me show you once again. This is the way one, if you are able to develop, look at this one. Using IMAP tool only, this concept mapping was developed. Okay. Now coming back to the other tools like shared document tools. You must have seen in my site professorkshrinivas.in. Google Docs are used extensively. Google Sheets are used extensively. Google Slides are used. Etherpad. Apart from that, Etherpad, Scatterspoke, and Idea Boards are also could be very much helpful. The request what I am making to all of you is try to use the cloud storage to the extent possible, which is very, very important. Of course, a lot of sticky notes tools like Jamboard, which is wonderful tool, so that it's again provides a wonderful collaborative learning environment which could be the need of. Apart from Jamboard, IdeaFlip and Linoid is also very much helpful for you. Assessment and activities are very, very important. See, one way of doing is you can use a learning management system to do the needful. But before going for a learning management system, what I'm trying to say that you can use the this kind of formative summative assessment tools like Quizzy, Quizly, Socrates, Pluckers, and Tesmos kind of a thing. And as well as the formative assessment tools like Mentimeter, Poll Everywhere. Mentimeter we have been using quite often, Pigeonhole, and so on and so forth. And asynchronous learning tools like Google Classroom, Moodle, Canvas, Edmodo, and Blackboard. And these are the tools which can be used. And of course, the synchronous learning tools are this. Okay. And let me go back once again to the place where it was started. So for the blended learning environment, which has been a policy statement in our new educational policy. Now let me ask one of the participants to read out Dr. Chetan Ingale. Dr. Chetan, can you hear me? I've been asking the people to be available. Dr. Gajanan, are you available?
Yes, sir.
Can you please read out this slide, please?
Yes, sir. Blended learning, given the emergence of digital technologies and the emerging importance of leveraging technology for teaching, learning at all levels from school to higher education. The NEP 2020 recommends for use of blended models of learning. The NEP 2020 states that while promoting digital learning and education, the importance of face-to-face in-person learning is fully recognized. Accordingly, different effective models of blended learning will be identified for appropriate replication for different subjects.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. So I think this is the policy statement which was made in the NEP, or New Educational Policy 2020, about the blended learning. Of course, they are recognizing the importance of this. So as I already told you that because we started from back to front, so it will be much easier for you. No need to understand. This blended learning consisting of, again, let me go back. The primary objective of the blended learning is about the four important things. We want to make the learning impactful, engaging, interesting, and challenging. The advantages, of course, are fine, but what is important to me that, of course, there are very interesting videos are there. I don't know, because these videos are not running in WebEx. I don't know how to run these things, but these are all the embedded things. The blended learning is applied to the practice of using both in-class and out-of-the-classroom learning experiences when teaching the students. Okay. So there is something called in-classroom learning. That means students are in front of you. In front of physical presence as well as the virtual presence is also acceptable to me. So can I request one of the participants, because these slides are important. I'll be asking, that's the reason to ask the people to read. Let me see that Dr. Prachiti, madam, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Madam, can you please read out this screen, madam?
In-class learning. The term in-class learning refers to all activities within the classroom or labs with physical presence of students and teacher, including, but not limited to, experiences such as teachers' explanations, demonstrations, large group activities, that is brainstorming and discussions, small group activities like group work, problem solving, and experiments.
Yeah. So what is important to me that whatever we have been doing in the presence of the students, physical presence of the students, we can. I've just mentioned few of them: teachers lecturing, explanations, demonstrations, large group activities like brainstorming and discussions, small group activities like group work, problem solving, experiments. But this is not limited to this part. You can go beyond this also. Not necessarily only this part can be taken care as such. Now, about the out of the classroom learning, I'll ask one more participant to Dr. Manoj H. Hole. Dr. Manoj, can you hear me? Dr. Maroti Vaga. Dr. Maroti. Dr. N.K. Lamba.
Yes, sir. I'm here, sir.
Yeah, Dr. N.K. Lamba, can you please read out, sir, this slide, please?
Yes, sir. Yes, definitely. Yes, sir. The term out-of-class learning refers to all activities outside the classrooms, labs with non-physical presence of students, including but not limited to experiences such as accessing resources with or without digital devices, books, newspapers, journals, PDF, videos, audios, files, web page, e-books, e-journal, etc., and getting involved in interaction with paper, with peers and community, online collaboration, group project with classmates outside classroom, visit to workshop offices in surrounding.
Okay, thank you, sir. So what is important is 1 minute. There is an urgent message, so I'm just typing an urgent message. Okay, so out of the classroom refers to all the activities a student can do out of the classroom and with non-physical presence of the students, including. So in the non-physical presence of the students, what is important to me? The first and foremost thing, students need to access the resources with or without the digital devices. Okay. And the books and newspapers, printed journals, printed PDF, lecture notes. I think it has been missed over here. Let me just take out the lecture notes also. Lecture notes. And these are all could be part of the lecture notes, could be part of the without the digital devices we can use. And of course, audio files, web pages, ebooks. So what is important is you should create the environment in such a way that students can able to access. I think that's what the exercise, the project work also had given to you. Second point is about getting involved in interaction with peers and community. This is very important, like online collaboration. For online collaboration, there are multiple ways to do it. Either you can use the Jamboard or you can use the Padlet. Or you can use the discussion forum kind of a thing. Group projects also, these are some of the tools can be used for that purpose as such. And of course, visit to the workshops. And so these are the two important things one needs to understand about the blended mode of teaching. So the tools and are very important. Now, so what are the core components of this blended learning? The core components of blended learning consisting of three sides of a triangle. First one is about the hardware. If you look at the laptops and desktops and smartphones, webcams, microphones, writing devices, pen tabs also to be very important to be and need to understood. Second one is about software. The software which is facilitating the learning of the learners. Something like there are two types of learnings which is the softwares are going to support. One is about the synchronous learning. So as I already told you that either students can come to the class or it should be supporting the synchronous learning using the synchronous tools. Even our face-to-face classroom is also called as a synchronous learning tool. Synchronous learning happens during the real-time face-to-face classes. Here the students can interact, discuss, share and develop the perspective. This is very, very important one has to understand. Interact, discuss, and share the develop the perspectives to all the content the students have studied and absorbed during the asynchronous mode. Okay. Now, can I request one of the participants? I'll let me read out the name of the people to see that whether they are available. Can I request Dr. Surbhi Jain? Dr. Surbhi Jain. Dr. Surbhi Jain.
Yes, sir.
Surbhi, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Madam, can you read out this one? I am asking you to read, madam.
Okay. Shared component shared learning.
Madam, थोड़ा जोर से बोलिएगा, आपका आवाज बहुत बहुत कम आ रहे हैं.
Okay, sir. Shared components blended learning. In this asynchronous learning, objectives of asynchronous learning includes activities which students can pursue beyond their class hours. Oblique schedule. This helps build contained knowledge and allows students to apply learning in creative ways. Recorded lectures, e-contained simulations are particularly well suited for asynchronous learning, as students can watch recorded sessions and read the e-content in their own free time, thus ensuring maximum and effective utilization of the time marked for live classes in face-to-face interactions and discussions. Asynchronous learning tools, Moodle, / Google Classroom, / Canvas, / Edmodo, / Blackboard.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you very much. So this asynchronous learning, which is supporting the main objective of this one, is so that it should support the activities which student can pursue beyond their class hours and schedule. And any learning management system, whether it be a Moodle, Google, but what is important to me, that again I am going back to that first important point of how do we plan and execute the plan and design your course. So if you are clear about what are the things to be done, like for example, the asynchronous learning includes the activities which student can pursue beyond their class hours and schedule, that's very, very important to do. Apart from this, this next important thing is about can I request the participant, Dr. Umesh, can you hear me?
Yes sir.
Can you read, sir?
Am I audible, sir?
You're good, sir. Go ahead.
Okay, sir. Advantages of blended instructional method: convenience of access to wide variety of study material. Learner can learn on own pace and time. Students can engage with the content in variety of format, video, text, audio, and can choose the format that suit them best. Student can watch videos and read the content multiple times to help absorb content. Wide variety and range of materials can be presented to increase learner choice.
So the one of the important thing which is about what is the advantage of providing the material in this asynchronous learning. First, सबसे बड़ा एडवांटेज ये है, स्टूडेंट को अपने टाइम में, अपने पेस में, अपने स्पेस में पढ़ाने के लिए एक मौका मिलेगा. दिस इज वन ऑफ द वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग थिंग. सेकेंड थिंग इज, स्टूडेंट्स कैन एंगेज विद द कंटेंट इन ए वेराइटी ऑफ फॉर्मेट्स. So this is second very important thing. And the third important thing is, student can watch and read the content multiple times to absorb the content. And of course, variety of content can be provided over there. The next important thing is about, very, very important in this blended learning environment, is collaborative learning. Let me request one more participant to kindly read this one. Dr. Sunita. Dr. Sunita Nithuri Ravidas. Madam, Dr. Sunita, can you hear me? Can I request Dr. Krutarth Jamkar?
Yes, sir.
Madam, can you please read? Dr. Sunita bol rahe?
Krutarth Jamkar.
Madam, aap padh lijiye, Krutarth ji, aap padh lijiyega, please.
Advantages: blended instructional method, opportunity for collaborative learning. Student can collaborate with with each other for enhanced and enriched peer learning, like shared documents and message board that act as support in and out of class. Inclusive learning through diversity of perspectives. Guest speakers from around the world can be invited much more conveniently in online sessions to share their experiences, sir.
Okay. So what is this collaborative learning? See, learning from the peers is very, very important. It's not only learning. Again, you go back to the slide maine aapko jo dikhaya tha. उस स्लाइड में मैंने आपको कहा था कि लर्निंग लर्निंग कैन बी डन फ्रॉम द डिफरेंट सोर्सेस वन फ्रॉम द ओनली टीचर मोड पे नहीं टीचर के साथ साथ देर आर सो मेनी ऑप्शंस आर अवेलेबल वी हैव टू लर्न बट द अपॉर्चुनिटी शुड बी क्रिएटेड बाय द टीचर कंसर्न ओनली इन दिस रिगार्ड दिस इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट डॉक्टर प्रीति हाउ लॉन्ग आई कैन कंटिन्यू इन दिस सेशन
सर इट इज अप टू 2:00 ऑन टाइम
I'll just summarize in just maximum five minutes. So the competencies of blended teaching learning, which is very much need of the hour. And of course, there is a reference to the new educational policy, but my request to all of you is, I hope you understand. So blended teaching learning consisting of two important components. One, interacting the students in front of you. Second one is interacting the students at home, engaging the students at home. So when the students are coming to the campus for 2 days, or when you are teaching the students with a virtual synchronous learning environment, it is more or less same to me. But what is important to me that how do we plan this kind of environment? So I have told you that I have given you one small practical exposure, practical project work, where you need to plan a course for 2 weeks in classroom learning experience. Students are coming 2 days in a week, or 5 days वो घर से पढ़ेंगे. और इसके लिए मैंने आपको कहा था कि आपको 5-5 मिनट के 4 videos आपको बनाना है, और list भी मैंने आपको दिखाया. उसमें से कोई भी tool आपको use कर सकते हैं, क्योंकि अभी समय का अभाव से मैंने नहीं कर पाया. शायद आपके आगे 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 सेशंस में एक कंटेंट डेवलपमेंट टूल्स के बारे में आपको विस्तृत जानकारी मिल जाएगी. सेकंडली मेरे लिए एक और बात है कि आपके प्रोजेक्ट वर्क के लिए पर टॉपिक के लिए मुझे 2 supplementary videos आपको लेना है. उसके लिए भी मैंने आपको एक 2 options बताया. वन इज डिजिटल इनिशिएटिव्स ऑफ गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया से भी आप ले सकते हो, या ओपन एजुकेशनल रिसोर्सेज से भी ले सकते हो. तीसरा सबसे इंपॉर्टेंट टेड टॉक से भी यू कैन फॉलो एंड यू कैन लिसन. एंड उसमें से ढूंढना कैसे वो भी मैंने बताया. टोटली आपके जो 2 supplementary videos फ्रॉम फॉर वन टॉपिक, सेम लॉजिक अप्लाइज फॉर द टेक्स्ट रिसोर्सेज आल्सो. ओके. एंड देन द थर्ड इंपॉर्टेंट फैक्टर वुड बी द डिस्कशन फोरम. And for discussion forum, you can use it because I could not able to explain much about that part as because once you have designed that part and developed the course content, then we'll go. So the blended learning is basically blending of the teaching learning experiences. This is what I wish to say. If you have while designing the course, you want to see that what are those experiences can be done. टू देन देयर इज अ बिग क्वेश्चन कम्स दैट सर आपने तो ये छोटे छोटे टूल्स हमें क्यों दिखाया. टूल्स इसलिए मैंने आपको दिखाया. इफ यू बेसिकली जनरली हम कोई स्टूडेंट्स को दिखाने से पहले वी वॉन्ट टू गेट एश्योर्ड दैट दीज टूल्स विल वर्क, वेदर इट कुड बी अ फॉर्मेटिव असेसमेंट टूल, इट कुड बी अ समेटिव असेसमेंट टूल, इट कुड बी अ पीयर असेसमेंट टूल, और इट कुड बी अ कॉन्सेप्ट मैपिंग एंड माइंड मैपिंग टूल. इफ यू कैन हैव विद अ कॉन्फिडेंस. एक चीज ध्यान रखिएगा, इफ यू आर अ प्रैक्टिशनर, इफ यू हैव थियोरेटिकल एक्सपोजर अलोंग विद द प्रैक्टिकल एक्सपोजर, योर आउटपुट विल बी टोटली डिफरेंट. आप जस्ट ओनली थियरिस्ट है. थियरी भी मैं मेरे ख्याल तो कोई गलत बात नहीं है, बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट भी है, बट व्हाट इज हैपनिंग इज इफ यू कन्फाइन टू ओनली थियोरेटिकल एस्पेक्ट्स, इफ यू कन्फाइन टू थियरी, एस्पेशली आईसीटी कैन नॉट बी अ थियोरेटिकल पार्ट. Unfortunately, because of this WebEx kind of a thing, I could not able to show many more, because most of my teachings all will be in a blended mode. Main thoda PPT dikha ke ya video dikha ke aage karna chahta tha. This is what in the nutshell, friends, I just want to show. And this is the step-by-step process. Maine kuch dots ko connect karne ki koshish kiya tha, aur baki dots bhi aapke jo is wale one wonderful workshop mein, Dr. Preeti, Professor Dete, and the entire, you have a wonderful team of resource persons will be there. If you have any specific questions other than the ones which I cleared or you asked, and I'm happy to answer another, I'll take another 2-3 extra minutes. Aapka bhi lunch time hai, mera bhi lunch time hai, but still mera lunch time to chalta rehta hai. So maine socha ki aapka, if you have any specific doubts are there, you are free to ask.
Thank you so much, sir. Friends, aapko kuch puchna hai, kuch query hogi to puchiye.
जो मैंने कल लिंक्स भी दिया था उसके अंदर सब कुछ आपको दे रखा है. सो उसमें रीडिंग मटेरियल से लेके प्रोजेक्ट वर्क हैज टू बी एंश्योर्ड डॉक्टर प्रीति.
यस, वेरी वेरी
वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. बिना प्रोजेक्ट वर्क का तो आई डोंट सी दैट, बिकॉज़ देन ओनली दे कुड एबल टू कंसीडर. यस डॉक्टर लाबा,
एक्सक्यूज मी.
जी बताइए.
Yes, sir, you wonderfully explain each and everything. I think there is no questions, no doubt in all of us, the participants. From my side, I just want to ask a very, ek choti si cheez main aapse puchna chahunga, whether you are teaching from this mode from last so much years, but offline medium is, I think, much better than this online medium, sir.
Sir,
main
ek baat batau. दोनों मेरे लिए बराबर है, बट अल्टीमेटली इसमें टीचिंग होना चाहिए. बट इसमें इस मीडियम भी देखिए, अभी तो करंट माहौल को देखे, ये तो ठीक कर रखा है. बिकॉज अब पहले हमने इतना एक्सप्लोर नहीं किया गया था ये सारे चीज, अभी आगे आगे इसको और एक्सप्लोर करने की आवश्यकता है. ये ब्लेंड इसलिए मैं आपको कह रहा हूँ, आप जब क्लासरूम के पहले जिस विषय के ऊपर आपने जो पढ़ाना था उसको थोड़ा सा इंफॉर्मेशन उनको देके अब क्लासरूम में इंटरेक्ट करने की कोशिश करो, देन योर क्लास विल बी डिफरेंट क्लास. बिकॉज बाहर के माहौल अभी जो जिस ओमिक्रॉन का ही मैं बात कर रहा हूँ, अब सब जगह पर लोग डरे हुए हैं. अब ये दोनों राज्यों में, महाराष्ट्र में भी इतना फैल रहे और दिल्ली में भी इतना फैल रहे और ऑल पूरे हिंदुस्तान में. सो बेटर टू सेफ अवर सेल्फ at the same time and not at the cost of the quality. So there are so many options are available, we need to explore. Jaruri nahi hai ki only one option, but yes, if you given me chance, face to face is the best, no doubt about it. But pichle 2 saal se sir, ek chote se main bata raha, 2 saal se ek bhi college nahi khuli Delhi mein, ek bhi school nahi khuli. But main kehta hu ना खोलने के वजह से ऐसा नहीं कि, बट मेनी टीचर्स आई नो मेनी टीचर्स, क्योंकि मैं उनके साथ तो अभी जुड़ा हूँ कई दिनों से, ऑलमोस्ट दिन से दिन में मेरा अभी आपका क्लास खत्म होते ही 2:30 बजे से मेरा एक और क्लास है और ये भी मिनिस्ट्री का मीटिंग है. मेरा कहने का मतलब ये है कि वी नीड टू एक्सप्लोर, और जो एक्सप्लोर करने वाले चीज में हमारे साथियों तक लेके जाइए, बहुत आसान तरीका है, इसे कोई बात नहीं. बट जब दैट्स अ नीड ऑफ द आवर. अभी तो हम इसको ये करके स्टूडेंट, सर आप देखिए कॉलेजेस खोलने के बावजूद भी, मैं एक पेरेंट हूं, मैंने दोनों बच्चों को कॉलेज भेजा नहीं, मैंने सिर्फ यही लिख के भेजा था भाई, इफ यू कैन इनोवेट, इफ यू कैन क्रिएट दिस काइंड ऑफ एनवायरनमेंट, ऑनलाइन ही चल रहे थे. बिकॉज सेफ्टी ऑफ द चिल्ड्रन इज सुपर मोस्ट, सेफ्टी ऑफ द टीचर्स इज सुपर मोस्ट. यस, टुमारो एवरीथिंग सबसाइडेड, I'm the first person to send my children to the school and going to the college. But till that time, sir, kuch na kuch tarike aapne apnana hi padega. to make the learning
Yes, definitely, sir. You are very much right, sir. Definitely, you are very much right. But the, especially we people are following all these things when such type of crisis has been observed in our society. Before that, we are nothing think about all these things, sir.
मैं एक छोटी सी बात लम्बा जी बता दूं अभी नागपुर यूनिवर्सिटी ने मैं तकरीबन 8-9 साल से जुड़ा हूं कितने बार आया मैंने कितने बार ओरिएंटेशन प्रोग्राम हमने किया था सो माय पॉइंट इज दैट फेस टू फेस पे बहुत सारे बट जब तक नीड ऑफ द आवर नहीं आता ना नेसेसिटी द मदर ऑफ इन्वेंशन तो तब तक हम लोगों ने इतना सोचा ही नहीं था जब मैं पहले ऑनलाइन की बात करता था लोग हंसते थे अरे पता नहीं कौन सा ऑनलाइन लेक्चर दे रहे हैं ऑनलाइन लेक्चर दे रहे हैं बट नाउ इट बिकेम अ नीड ऑफ द आवर एनीवे नो प्रॉब्लम लेट्स होप फॉर द बेस्ट थिंग्स कैन हैपन
थैंक यू सर एनी मोर क्वेश्चन सर सम पार्टिसिपेंट्स आर आस्किंग फॉर योर कॉन्टेक्ट डिटेल्स कैन यू शेयर विद देम
प्लीज प्लीज कर लीजिए
यस सर So, sir, on behalf of UGC HRDC Nagpur, I extend my thanks to Professor K. Srinivas, sir, for wonderful sessions starting from 11 o'clock on blended learning, a step-by-step approach. Thank you so much, sir, for your expertise in this field. Thank you so much. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Preeti. Thanks to Dr. Dete for providing me this opportunity to interact with the participants. All the best. Keep safe. And you know, mastak ko use kar lijiyega and keep maintaining the social distance. Keep safe.
Thank you
very much.
Good day, sir. Thank you.
Good day. Thank you.
Thank you all of you. Now we will have a lunch break. अभी देखिए late हो गया है थोड़ा 2:15 अभी बज गया है तो अपन next session start करेंगे 2:45 जो अपना 2:30 का था अब आप आधे घंटे का lunch break ले लीजिए 2:45 अपना last session रहेगा that will be on soft skill. Okay? So now I'm ending the meeting. आप 2:45 join करिए sharp.
Okay ma'am.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay ma'am.
Yes.
Thank you ma'am.